So here, welcome to this another episode with me, Arshi, and I'm here with another episode, or guest episode, जो है NIA Pune through CMAT 2023. I think बहुत सारे exams student दे चुके हैं, वो exams में हो सकता है उनका percentile इतना नहीं अच्छा रहा हो, and that is the reason they have this last hope with CMAT examination. राइट और अगर हम टॉप कॉलेजेस की लिस्ट में बात करें थ्रू सीमैट तो NIA इज आल्सो वन ऑफ द कॉलेजेस व्हिच कम्स अंडर द अम्ब्रेला राइट पर यू नो हम इंटरव्यू प्रोसेस परसेंटाइल सब पे डिस्कशन करेंगे बट सबसे पहला क्वेश्चन है कि अगर हम NIA की बात करें इट्स अ गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज इट्स अ वेरी ओल्ड कॉलेज पर बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स के दिमाग में होता है ना कि मुझे NIA जाना चाहिए नहीं जाना चाहिए बिकॉज ये थोड़ा सा नीश कोर्स कराता है स्पेसिफिकली इन टू इंश्योरेंस सो आई मीन किन स्टूडेंट्स के लिए कैन NIA जो है वो सही ऑप्शन हो सकता है हाउ टू डिसाइड दैट वेदर शुड आई यू नो आई शुड गो फॉर इट और नॉट
सो आई वुड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सजेस्ट दैट यस यू शुड श्योरली टेक अप NIA एज अ वेरी गुड थिंग as an organization wherein you can join, you can excel, and you can you know that insurance is a sunrise industry, right? So there is a lot of scope there. It is just an emerging something which is going on from past 2-3-4 decades, but it is not yet flourished. So this is the time when the industry itself is evolving at a very rapid pace. So a candidate who wants to pursue insurance, NIA is the best place he can go to because since the first and the last thing that every aspirant should keep in mind is its nicheness. It's very niche to its course that it is one of a kind college which gives you dual specialization into insurance as well as general management. So general management specifically into risk management because here in NIA, we are taught to be an insurance and risk management professionals. So somebody who is from technical as well as non-technical background, be it from commerce, be it a candidate from BBA, be it a person having his bachelor's done in BSc, maybe in science, arts, anybody who is aspiring to be a part of insurance industry, who is aspiring to be a part of something that is going to be the future of the country, should actually join NIA. And talking about NIA, NIA being a very beautiful campus placed in Pune, it's a 32 acres campus, residential campus, everything over here, state of the art campus you can say. But something which fascinates me more is its learning process because we have both insurance subjects as well as we have general management subjects like IT, finance, HR, marketing, ye sari cheeze to tum seekhoge hi. But apart from that, you will also learn insurance subjects to the core so that you are ready to be a part of insurance industry directly as an assistant manager or you can after being a management trainee for what 6 months and then you are ready to be an assistant manager. So you are already at that level where you are entering that industry at a particular position which will be impacting your future or your career growth, right? So my personal experience over here at NIA was very beautiful. Like you can say, I already mentioned being a candidate who have scored like 34 percentile in CAT and I have scored like 97.3 percentile in CMAT. So the candidates who are like demotivated because of their CAT score, I would want to suggest them that no, that was not the end. That was just a start. So that was something which was there for you to learn out of this. And then, as I said, go on practicing. The further you move, you might get more opportunities, just like I did. So I gained one by going to NIA. So I would suggest the aspiring students to like take up this thing very seriously because NIA is one of a kind college. It is backed by central government, central agencies. It is backed by PSUs. It has recognition around the globe, not just in India, but around the globe. Because here at NIA, we even have MDP, like management development programs, wherein we even invite students from, like we have professionals from Southeast Asia, Middle Eastern countries and all. So you get that kind of exposure. Going to like any good B school or something, they don't have this cross-country program, but our college has that. And you get to know industry from their perspective as well. You can interact with them. So there are a lot of things which are there only in NI and you cannot get it anywhere, any other like insurance college.
Yeah, so moving to the next question, you know, all those aspirants, you know, who are planning to apply through CMAT, I mean, I think we were discussing your percentile was 97 plus, if I'm not wrong, right? But what is the safe percentile ki, I mean, is percentile pe, you know, jo hai students tall expect kar sakte
hai. I'll suggest that being a general candidate, if you are applying for NI, it's better you have a percentile more than 90 for your CMAT. You'll surely get call. And further to that, it just depends upon your performance in the written ability test, then GDs, PIs, etc. So all that. But minimum you should target for 90 percentile at least to apply for NI. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So the second question is, we were like discussing before this video that the, you know, at your time the seat were like 100. So currently, yeah, what is the seat intake of the college?
Currently, you can say we have a batch of 136 students. So they were planning to expand, but there is no official confirmation on it. But if at all there is some expansion in the seats, that will be reflected in our official website.
Adding to one more question, you know, do they have some, you know, quota, you know, seats, you know, when it comes to general SC, ST, or like it's there's no reservation criteria? So
being a government college, they do follow this category seat matrix, so it is there. There are candidates who might get selected from OBC, NT, SC, NT, or you can say EWS categories as well, apart from being a general candidate. So need not to worry, there are seats for these candidates as well.
Okay, next question ki, let's say maine score kar liya, meko call aa gaya NIA Pune se, kyunki you know ज्यादातर कॉलेजेस का जो इंटरव्यू प्रोसेस होता है, I mean, they have very generic questions. I mean, yeah. Why MBA? Where you see yourself? But I've seen with colleges जिनके थोड़े से niche courses होते हैं, अगर हम बात करें, तो उनके जो इंटरव्यू प्रोसेस होते हैं वो थोड़े से बाकी कॉलेजेस से डिफरेंट होते हैं. तो हाउ इज योर जर्नी, यू नो, और स्टूडेंट्स किस तरह से प्रिपेयर कर सकते हैं इफ दे हैव यू नो NIA इन देयर लिस्ट?
सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड सजेस्ट दैट यू नीड नॉट टू थिंक इन अ मैनर कि यू विल बी आस्क्ड क्वेश्चंस अबाउट इंश्योरेंस पर्टिकुलरली इन योर इंटरव्यू, बिकॉज being applying to a college like NIA, even the NIA people, like we even know that the candidate who are applying are not aware of insurance to an extent which can be asked in the interview. But yeah, there are some basic questions which are very much practical and a candidate should actually think on it before joining to NIA. So first of all, when you get a call from NIA, you get a list of like 10 to 20 topics which you are supposed to prepare before your interview. At our time, we got this. So there might be a chance that this might repeat. So it's like an extempore which they take at the time of personal interview. But extempore depends upon whether the topics will be disclosed or not. So that is something that I am not sure about, because that the management decides at the time of personal interviews. But apart from that, if a candidate goes to a personal interview, he is very certain to be asked like regarding your background and specialization that you did your graduation into, then what made you choose NIA after your degree in either engineering, or if you have any technical degree, so why do you want to be from a technical background and go into something like insurance? So I must clarify that even insurance is something that is very much technical. You require a lot of technical knowledge while assessing the claims, while going forward with the surveys and all. So your technical thing is something that makes you stand out of the box. So technical knowledge is required. So engineering graduates specifically need not to worry that main engineer hu, mera insurance mein kya kaam hai. Nahi, aapka kaam hai aur bahut zyada kaam hai, because technical graduates are somebody who are a part of insurance industry from a very long time. The another questions may be like, what new you could bring to the table in insurance with your knowledge from your past degree. So you need to relate your past degree ka knowledge with your the knowledge which you think you can gain in insurance from NIA. So you have to have a beforehand like a thoda sa prerequisite knowledge that yes, I'll do this. I am from engineering background. If I join NIA, I'll be taught this. Then furthermore, I'll have certain things to add up to the table. So the one can think in that notion as well. Then the candidate can prepare the eminent personalities, MDs, CEOs of different PSU, top general insurance companies, the latest trends which are going into insurance, the financial budget which is being declared by the finance minister. So is there any specific provision, specific changes which are to be made, like are made in insurance particularly? Then insurance penetration and standing of India as compared to the global, like global insurance market. So this can be also asked. This is little way too much, but I was prepared for all these questions, so I am giving them my personal, like my preparation I am giving it to them. So like also you can say that what fascinates you about insurance industry, in particularly about insurance industry, that you think that yes, I can pursue my career in insurance, because insurance industry is flourishing industry. So being in a process of evolution, what made you so much fascinated about insurance that you plan to do your MBA program in insurance and risk management?
So Aman, the process is online or offline?
No ma'am, the process during pandemic was online, but the standard process is offline only. We hold offline processes at majorly three locations, Delhi, Mumbai and Pune. There might be some more. There are offline interviews, offline GDs, written ability tests and all. So all the process is conducted offline.
Now, last few questions. I mean, can you just, I mean, you are already in the initial of this, but you have told much about NIA, why you want to join NIA. But obviously, किसी भी कॉलेज को हम देख रहे होते हैं तो देयर इज दिस क्वेश्चन कॉल्ड रिटर्न इन इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड फॉर दैट आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क यू नो हाउ मच फीस यू हैव पेड एंड अगेंस्ट दैट व्हाट इज दो यू नो देयर इज प्लेसमेंट ब्रोशर एंड ऑब्वियसली गवर्नमेंट कॉलेजेस में यूजुअली क्या होता है सारे फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर जो है वो काफी क्लियर होते हैं they don't have to override hybrid so you know fees against the placements that is two things what I wanted to know from your end.
Okay, so like our total academy fee is 9.43 lakhs for 2 years. Apart from that, we have 3.07 lakhs for our mess and boarding, lodging boarding you can say. So it goes roughly to 12.5 you can say all over. And as mentioned even in our brochure and all, you pointed this out very in a like specific manner that yes, government colleges need not to boast about their placements, but they don't hype it, so even we don't. Everything that is there in the brochure or even on the official website is genuine, and there is no scope of inflation in our figures from our end. So yeah, I think that the return on investment is 1:1. Like if you are investing like 12.5 and you are getting a college which has a median salary of like 13 lakhs, then I guess you should go for it, because there is a thing called as learning. You will start, you will get a head start of like 13 lakhs, 12.5 to 13 lakhs at the beginning, and you go on in that figure itself will go on increasing. So it won't be 13 lakhs for you. By the time you enter the next year, it might get increased by like 10%, 18%, 20%, whatever. So yeah, it gives you a good head start, I must say.
And what is the one last suggestion you want to give to all those students that how they can maximize their MBA, you know?
I would focus more on some 2-3 things. So first of all, I would like to say that focusing on the college life, the journey you spent, like this 2 years will be probably the last degree which everybody of you will be having. Post this, there will be only few of the candidates who will go for PhD or double postgraduates or maybe executives. But after, this is the last degree, this is the last time you will be spending in campus, you will be a student over there. So as a student, the first and the basic thing which you should do is like look after yourself, make yourself, groom yourself holistically in a manner that you are ready to be a part of corporate world, because there is a complete another level competition you can say over there in corporates. Here at NI, if I specifically talk about my college, I have like 100 students in total who are studying with me, but like I am one of them. So I need to compete here with just 99 or 98 of them. But when you go to a corporate world, that particular scenario is open for all. At that core position, you have to showcase yourself with something that adds value to your work by something that you have done in your post-graduation degree. So I would suggest them to go for some certification course. There are some III courses which that are specifically for insurance professionals. take help of your the students who are studying with you. You go, you have that peer-to-peer learning. Peer-to-peer learning is something that a MBA graduate is supposed to do throughout these 2 years. You sit in, you form groups, groups on the basis of your learning experiences. You make friends for yourself to help you out in something that is academic as well as extracurriculars, because extracurriculars even will groom you in a manner that will make you ready for the corporate world or being called as a manager. Develop your leadership skills, develop your oratorships, then go for different certification courses, maybe data, maybe something like analytics, go for risk management. Risk management is something which is very much emerging and is very much in demand in this scenario. Go for any different courses which relates you to that particular MBA degree, whichever college you go, whichever course you pursue into. Like if you are going into any college which has IT, or you are being an operations, you are doing a MBA in operations, so look for some courses which are which the people all over are doing who are pursuing MBA in operations. Like I did my like III, we have like licentiate, associate and fellow program. So it is a degree you can say you can attain apart from your degree which you will be getting from your PG. So I'll suggest them to go for some certified course. Apart from that, focus on your holistic development altogether. Maintain very good relations with your faculty members, because even those people are very corporate people. They can help you in your near future. Keep a good bond with your friends, because they are going to be there in the corporate world with you, working with you. You might need their help, so you need to keep that bond. And last but not the least, I would suggest never stop yourself from learning new things, evolving, adapting new things, adapting people, adapting the environment, and yes, being ready for the challenges in your life.
Okay, Prajwal, thank you so much for your time. I think I'm done with my questions. Thank you. And I think definitely this video will help a lot of aspirants who have, you know, NIA in their list. So yeah, thank you. Okay.
Thank you, man.